Hello and welcome to Smart Vision. You may have seen recent news that Google can create a picture book from a single prompt. That's amazing. But did you know you can also create a long, story-driven video on a local PC with just 8 GB of VRAM using a single prompt? In this video, I'll walk you through a free workflow that takes one prompt and produces a long video on a local machine and even with only 8 GB VRAM. If you enjoy this video and want more, please like, share, and subscribe. All resources used in this video are available on my Patreon. Step 1. Install Ollama. Search for Ollama and download the appropriate installer for your OS. Install it like any other app and open it. Inside Ollama, you'll choose a local LLM. If your GPU has 16 GB or more, you can use GPTOSS20B or Gemma 327B. If you only have about 8 GB, use Gemma 3 for B. The B stands for model size. Larger models usually give higher accuracy but need more VRAM. After you finish selecting the model, choose the download location here. Then say hello and it will automatically start downloading the model. When the download is complete, enable the setting so comfy UI can connect to Ollama. You can also increase the context length here to let the AI generate longer stories, but note this will use more memory. If you don't want to risk leaking any data, you can enable airplane mode. Step 2 is downloading Comfy UI. Search for Comfy UI on Google, go to the official site, and choose the installer for your OS. I'm using Windows. After downloading, install and open Comfy UI. You will see the main interface. Now import the workflow I designed. Just drag it into the UI. Then open Comfy UI Manager and click Install Missing Node to install any missing nodes. Take a look at the entire workflow. It consists of 3 main steps. The first module generates a story from your prompt, converts the story into multiple storyboard image prompts, and then generates the corresponding motion prompts for those images. The second module generates images based on the storyboard image prompts. The third module generates a video using the images and the motion prompts. The fourth and fifth modules increase the video's frame rate and clarity. The first step uses the Ollama model we just downloaded. I chose GPTOSS20B. If your GPU has only 8 GB of VRAM, choose GEMMA3 for B. This workflow uses 3 AI roles. Why 3 roles? Guiding the AI step by step produces more accurate output. It's similar to a more detailed chain of thought. You can also choose whether to enable internal thinking and to preserve context to improve success rate. Assign each AI model a role. For example, the first model acts as the director and generates a story from the prompt. Enter the prompt at this field to tell it what story to generate. The second model is also a director, but this one turns the story into storyboard frames. Storyboard frames are image prompts. This node saves those prompts. The third director writes the motion prompts for each storyboard frame, which are used to generate the video. When everything is ready, click Run and after a short wait you'll see the generated story, storyboard and motion prompts. You might wonder why we don't generate video directly from text. The reason is accuracy. Direct text to video is hard to control and the video quality is difficult to manage. Generating images first makes it easier to inspect and control intermediate results. And it gives us many ways to control image style and maintain character consistency later. After generation, open the text files to check the prompts. If you're not satisfied, you can edit them. Note that each prompt must be on a single line. Sometimes the generated output includes blank lines between prompts. You need to delete those blank lines. Next, close the first node group and open the second module. This module reads the storyboard descriptions you just generated and batch produces images. I use the latest powerful open source image model, FluxKRE8F. Here you need to write the path to the storyboard text file you saved earlier. Enter the image height and width here, and the output folder for the images here. Then just click Run. You can go do other things while it runs. When it finishes, come back and check the results. It's very hands-off. Because these are local PC models, their accuracy may not match services like VEO or Midjourney, so generate several batches to increase your chances of getting good results. Now let's look at the results. The AI wrote a story about a cat and a dog. If you want better control over character consistency, I recommend using Flux Context. For example, here we select a character from the images we just generated, place the character image here, fill in the scene prompt here, and it will generate images of that character in the scene. Very useful. It can generate scene images based on the pictures you provide. Then, close the second module and open the third module. This module reads the images you generated in the motion prompts to create the video. I use the latest 1.2 model for video generation. Similarly, enter the path to the motion prompts, the path to the generated images, and the video height and width here. Click Run to start. You can also generate multiple variants to improve your success rate. Because this module needs to generate videos, it will use a large amount of memory. It can sometimes cause Comfy UI to crash. So at the end of this module, I added cache cleanup nodes. These nodes clear memory after each generation so subsequent runs aren't affected. But if Comfy UI still crashes due to memory issues, you'll need to restart Comfy UI, reduce the image size, or add more memory. Finally, we can use modules 4 and 5 to make the video higher resolution and smoother. See, the final result is more powerful than Google's storybook feature, and ours is a video. Pretty useful, right? This workflow still has room for improvement, such as automatic voiceover and full automation. I will add those features in future versions to make creation even easier. If you find this workflow useful, please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss updates. Thanks for watching. See you next episode. At last, let's see the result together.
A pampered Persian named Cleo and a scruffy street terrier, Rocco, are forced to share a quiet Victorian home after the owner, kindly Eleanor, has an accident. Cleo's life of velvet cushions and silver dishes collides with Rocco's energetic, messy street habits. At first there's chaos. Vases topple, hisses and barking. But a thunderstorm reveals a softer side. Rocco instinctively comforts frightened Cleo and small moments. Shared sunbeams, a stolen salmon turned playful chase. Slowly turn rivalry into friendship. As Eleanor recovers, Marcus watches them curl up together, and the house feels whole again, warmed by an unlikely bond.